Okay, in this video we're going to look at configuring AppLocker. So let's go into our group policy editor. And from our local group policy editor we just arrange the window so we can see everything. And under computer configuration window settings, we want to click on security settings, application control policies. And from here we can see we've got our app locker. Now if I expand that, we've got executable rules, Windows installer and script rules, but we want to go ahead and create a new executable rule. Now I'm going to rearrange the window a little bit here because of the screen resolution of the recording we can't see everything. So we're going to choose to hide the taskbar. And then from here we're next on the wizard. Now we want to deny an application to the Contoso research group. So let me just type in a name and then click check names. I'm going to say next. And we want to block an application, and we're going to do it using a path rule. So we'll browse files. If we click on our C drive, we want to go into program files, and what we're going to block is Windows Media Player. So we'll select Windows Media Player, then wmplayer.exe. We'll say next and then complete the wizard. And we'll say yes to create the default rules. Okay, from here let's go into the properties of AppLocker. And what we're going to do is we're going to configure our enforcement policies, and we're going to enforce the rules for executable files. With that done, we'll minimize our group policy. And we'll put our taskbar back. Now what we're going to do is a GP update using an administrative command prompt. Okay, with that done, we need to go into computer management. And from there, we're going to select services. And we're going to go into the properties of application identity, and we're going to set the startup type to automatic and then start the service. Okay, with that done, let's check our AppLocker rules. So we're going to log off and log on as a user in the research department. So we're going to log on as Contoso Allen. And from here, if we navigate to Windows Media Player, we can see it's blocked.